Kevin Hart is also stupid, and he's worked with the same group of stupid people since their very early days. And now apparently he won't come on a talk show without them. So please welcome Kevin Hart and the Plastic Cup Boys.
Wow.
Down some.
We here.
I'm really in my
cheap. You
fat ass on the wrong side.
That is it.
Yeah, one of y'all.
Hey,
yeah,
how y'all doing? Y'all good, too. Okay.
First of all, I want to say I had no idea you were this close with John Legend. Secondly, I feel totally in my comfort zone. I'm very happy to be surrounded by this many.
She's talking about black men.
Yeah.
Chelsea loves black men.
And I'm the darkest, Chelsea. That's all I'm saying. I'm the darkest, so that means you like me more.
You don't know that's my style. You don't know what I'm into.
I'm like the dark.
Yeah, no. I didn't say black men. He said it.
Oh, he said it.
I like being surrounded by, I was going to say men.
Oh, men, period. Oh.
Yeah.
Well, look who you're next to right now, but I ain't going to say nothing.
Whoa. A man.
Wow, we got off to a rough start.
0-2.
0-2.
Wait a minute.
Okay, listen, I respect this relationship. I like when Kevin, I said, Kevin, do you want to come on the show? And he said, actually, I have like 6 friends I want to bring with me. Or 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wow. And I said, you know what, bring them, because that's the kind of show this is. I like that you have this camaraderie, that you've been on the road, you've traveled all over the country, the world sometimes, right?
Yeah. I've been with these guys, some since day one, and some added as we got stronger. Joey and Harry were pieces that were added.
Pieces? Spank,
yeah, pieces. Joey and Harry. Joey's a comedian, Harry's a writer.
Comedian. Harry used to be a comedian.
Harry used to be a comedian.
Yeah,
didn't go good. Things didn't work out.
Yeah.
Right.
Harry, we called the audible. That's,
here, hold these up so I can remember your names because I don't
know. That's Harry right there. That's Harry.
Shit.
That's Harry.
Shit, my pants just became undone. Hold on.
Okay, here we go. Now the party starts.
That's what I do.
As they say in Spain, estoy lista.
Okay,
Naeem is you. Okay, good. Joey, that's Joey. I know you. Spank.
Spank.
That's right. And Wayne.
There we go.
Okay, and then Kevin.
What do you mean?
Oh, yeah, that's you.
Why do I need a name tag?
Okay, right. So tell us your story. What does everybody do here? Some of you are comedians. Some of you are failed comedians. What do you do?
I'm the one to keep everything together.
Are you the money guy?
Most of the times.
But you used to be the security guy, right? And then you transitioned
into... for 10 weeks. And I realized I couldn't drink, so security wasn't for me.
Right.
Nah. That's not true. You realized you couldn't drink or fight.
There you go. Hey, what are we talking about?
And then he said, it's for me.
Yeah, something happened in New York?
Like, there's a couple incidents where Wayne was like, man, this ain't for me, bro.
Okay, and so... And Harry, what do you do?
I started off doing what he does. Being an assistant, but...
I'm not nobody's assistant.
Ooh.
What you used to do.
Ooh. Okay.
He said used to.
What he used to do.
Yeah, I said used to.
Yeah. And then he found a talent in writing for me. I was a failed comedian, but...
We don't use the word failed around
no,
here.
No, I definitely failed.
You get booed. A couple times, though.
Yeah. Sorry?
You get TV a couple times. Shout your credits out. Comic View.
No, don't shout your credits out. No. Yeah, please don't. What are you fucking talking about? Shut up.
It's going so bad.
But I used to write for other comedians and punch up a lot of other comedians. And when I met Kev, we kind of had the same sensibility, so it just kind of matched.
Okay. Yeah. And so you guys travel all the time together. You spend a lot of time together, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And you guys have a show called Hart in the City that you guys created together, right?
Yes,
for Comedy Central?
Yes.
Joey, that's Joey.
Joey.
Joey Webb.
Thank you.
And that's about discovering young talent and kind of helping them, give them a boost?
Yes. We wanted to give, like, talent that's, like, it's a showcase show. So what happens is everybody knows New York and L.A. is where all the comedians come from. But we were like, yo, why don't we give chances to comedians like in the South, Midwest, where people don't really think about comedy? And we didn't want to go to the clubs. We went to where people start. So like lounges, bars, strip clubs.
Mm-hmm. Is that
it? Yeah. You ain't never been laughing until you go to a strip club and then you gotta go up and old girl chocolate come rolling down and then you gotta tell a joke and everybody go, fuck no, get the fuck out of here. So, yeah. So that's it.
Hilarious. Chelsea, you got your start in the same.
That's right. No, I was the manager of a strip club, Kevin. That's exactly what happened. I was the manager of a strip club and I was like, these girls suck, I'm getting up there.
Yeah.
And then that's what I did. Because I'm very protective over other women. And then I got up there and they said, you get out of here. And that's when I started doing stand-up. And so what are you guys, like, what do you think is the bond that keeps you guys all together? Because we talk about girl power and all that bullshit on this show a lot.
Yeah.
I want to hear from men what keeps a group of men together.
It's the money.
No, that's not.
It's definitely the money.
I think that's what keeps us around. Keeps us around.
That's not true.
We would have been gone a long time ago. It's the money.
Do you fight? Do you fight like girls?
Absolutely.
What do you fight about?
I whooped Kevin ass several times.
Yes. Men have fight. We fight. We fight. We didn't fight. We was about to fight.
No, y'all fought.
He pushed me down in the bathroom.
Why was y'all on the bathroom?
Because I wanted to fight him without people seeing.
Let's answer the question.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
The question is what keeps us together.
Thank you for staying focused.
Okay, here's the thing. I'm very strong in believing in the group that you keep around you is a representation of who you are. We keep a solid group around us, and our group carries a responsibility.
Of not being funny.
Well don't judge Spank by this, okay? Spank ain't, don't you judge him by
on
these.
On comedy, couples. Okay.
Right,
what should I judge him on?
Judge Spank, listen.
I have a half hour special on Comedy Central.
There you go. There you go, Spank. There you go, Spank. Fight, boy, fight. Fight, boy. No, but I think that we all literally have grown together, and I think when you get to see your crew really become successful within their own rights and they can branch off and do things as a representation of who you guys are as a unit. And we look back and we look at the road. And that circle that we have, nobody's popped that bubble. We don't allow other people to come into it because we have such a unique bond in the way that we move. And if somebody else comes into it, it alters what we do, you know?
You just added somebody last year, though.
Who did I add?
You added Boss. Every tour we go on, you add a new person.
Boss has been here 3 years. That's my trainer.
The last tour.
I'm the only one here that cares about my body.
No.
Who else?
Have you guys ever seen each other naked?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, we did a sketch that
we did a program. Oh,
yeah. I made them do a sketch.
That was
Wayne didn't do it.
Listen, I made them do a sketch for my
Let me explain.
And the whole premise around Let Me Explain was me doing things that I had to explain. So one of the sketches that I came up with, I said, yo, we're gonna go to like a dirt road. And we're all gonna come running over this hill naked. And I'm gonna impose a deer burr chasing us. And like we're all running from the deer burr, but we butt ass naked. And the whole joke behind it was, let me explain. I gotta explain why we're naked. So I convinced everybody to do it. We all out there, butt ass naked. And we run, we do it, right? We all laughing. We're like, man, it's gonna be crazy, it's gonna be funny. And I'm in the edit and I saw it, and I was like, this shit looks stupid. I was like, I ain't using this. So Wade was the only one that was like, I told y'all that shit was gonna be stupid. Wade wouldn't do it.
So let me ask you a more serious question, and anyone can answer this. What do you think has changed about Kevin the most since he's had such success?
No. Kevin takes more baths now. So when we first met Kevin, it was at least twice a week. But
it's
now
called a Kevin Hart shower.
Yes.
You just
it consists
cologne.
Of nothing but cologne. You spray it all
a lot.
And you
say, there's also another phrase for that, but I'm not saying what it is. Yeah, you can't say that anymore. No, you can't say a lot of things.
You know what, Kevin? Besides being cleaner, he hasn't really changed because he's always been an asshole, like the same shit that he's doing now. He's been doing it from day one. He's been a piece of shit from the beginning. And we can't say nothing. Like, you know what? He always been a piece of shit. We can't blame him on the money. So it's the same dude.
Consistent.
Yeah.
He don't pay on time. That's my
He don't pay on time. Mm-hmm.
Definitely not.
What is going on?
All checks are late.
This is actually an intervention.
Yeah. I'm like, surprise. Yeah. We want our money.
Yeah.
Here's the thing. They talk about me, right? Just to clear up so y'all don't think I'm a dirty ass. Let me tell you what they're talking about. I'm always on the go. So when we land and we get to a city, they can go to their hotels and go to sleep. I'm the guy that's got to land, and I got to go to the radio station. I got to go to the TV station.
Last time you went to a radio station for
promo. I do a bunch of stuff.
You don't do that.
I do stuff. I will agree with you. listen, when you have a crew of people, like my staff thinks I just lie in my fucking pool all day and then come in for an hour. They don't know what I'm up to, not much. But they, you know what I'm saying? They think I go tanning and then I go get my nails done and then some, you know, my doctor goes down on me. They don't know what I'm up to. They think I'm just living the life of Riley. And I'm not saying I'm not, but I do work harder than they know that I work. I just don't go in and advertise about it.
I advertise it.
Yeah, well, you should. I mean, it seems like you're paying a lot of people.
I do, and that's the thing. That's what's fucked up. I pay way too many people. To be honest, Chelsea, I realized this last year. I don't need y'all. I told y'all that.
Yeah.
I am so ready to cut this shit off. Right. I'm so ready to cut this shit off.
No. Most people say that once they've made it. But if you were to call him 7 years ago, he couldn't be alone. That's why we're all
around. No, of course not. And he does need you. And that's why he's paying you to stick around.
That's right.
All right, let me ask you a question, right? Within our group, here's a question for you. And I'm flipping your interview for a quick second. Out of our group here.
Yes.
From looking at, I'm going to show you the comedians, all right? You got, that's a comedian.
Yeah.
He's a comedian.
He's a comedian, okay?
Who would you say is the funniest comedian out of looking at these guys from our conversation?
Without you included, because I don't know these guys as well as I know you. I would say that you're funny. I can tell that you're funny. You're a little bit like under the radar. I would say you're the funniest because you look the smartest. I think smarter is funnier, right?
It's about time. Praise the Lord. Won't he do it? Won't he tell the truth?
Yeah.
What would you say about Naeem? What is Naeem?
I mean, he doesn't really said anything.
Hey, she knows.
So it's hard to say. But he's shy, and shy usually leads to funny. Mm, you know, when you get around the corner.
So I'm the worst. You said I'm the worst.
Yeah, you're the creepiest, for sure.
The creepiest. Again.
I have a half-hour special on Comedy Central going to man. And we got the Plastic Cup Boys special on Netflix.
On Netflix, so right here. Right here on Netflix.
Here we go, Spank.
Yeah.
Don't plug away.
Am I not getting no laughs? Well, get some
I had a really good time with you guys, and I'm really happy you all came. I like this. We're evening out the balance of my show. It's male friendly.
Oh, you made your quota for the year.
Yeah, yeah.
You don't need
no more black people.
You don't need another black
it's a wrap.
You go. Remember that episode with Kevin and the other black guys with him? We did it that episode. we made our quota.
Season 2 of Kevin Hart presents Heart of the City premieres Friday, November 3rd on Comedy Central, and you can go to KevinHartNation.com. For tickets to see the guys on the Irresponsible Tour.
Yes.
Hi, since you got to the end of that video, I'm gonna show you something that's going to blow your mind. I realize that I've never walked up this staircase on my set, and I don't know what's behind this door at the top, so we're just gonna find out together. And
hey guys, hit the subscribe button right now. For more videos.